Greetings. If you are Muslim, I encourage you to listen and learn what the prophets said about God, our Redeemer, and how that proves Jesus is Yahweh God. Job 19:25, "As for me, I know that my Redeemer lives, and at the last he will take his stand on the earth." Job is considered the oldest book in the Bible. So from this earliest time, God was known as the Redeemer. Notice what else Job has foretold or prophesied about the Redeemer. "And at the last, he will take his stand on the earth." God, the Redeemer, will take his stand on the earth. Come to the earth. Isaiah 59:20. "And the Redeemer shall come to Zion, and unto them that turn from transgression in Jacob, saith Yahweh the Lord." The Redeemer, meaning God, will come to Zion. Jeremiah 50:34. "Their Redeemer is strong. Yahweh, the Lord of hosts, is his name. He will vigorously plead their case so that he may bring rest to the earth, but turmoil to the inhabitants of Babylon." Isaiah 41:14. "Do not fear, you worm Jacob, you men of Israel. I will help you, declares Yahweh the Lord, and your Redeemer is the Holy One of Israel." Prophet Isaiah knew the Redeemer was the Holy One of Israel. Yahweh God is the Redeemer. He will redeem Israel. Psalm 19:14. "Let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Yahweh, Lord, my rock and my Redeemer." Psalm 78:35. "And they remembered that God was their rock, and the high God their Redeemer." Proverbs 23:11. "For their Redeemer is mighty, he shall plead their cause with thee." Isaiah 41:14. "Fear not, thou worm Jacob, and you men of Israel, I will help thee, saith Yahweh the Lord, and thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel." Isaiah 43:14. "Thus saith Yahweh the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, for your sake I have sent to Babylon, and have brought down all their nobles, and the Chaldeans whose cry is in the ships." Isaiah 44:6. "Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first, and I am the last, and beside me there is no God." I read this, and it grabbed my attention. And this is where my plans for this video went awry. But please stay with me, because I think this will be interesting and of value. Tally-ho! When we hear or read something, we interpret it based on both knowledge and assumptions. Let me give you an example that came to me as I lay in bed this morning meditating on the previous verse. The Eskimo built an ice house in blank. What text fills the space? An ice house or a nice house? One might assume Eskimo implies the frozen north. So an ice house seems the obvious meaning. But it also depends on the blank. In a hurry might mean he needed it to keep from freezing to death overnight. That too would support an ice house was said. But what if the blank is filled with California? In California would certainly not imply this was a house of ice. In California would support a nice house, as the actual words said. Wayne Gretzky, the great one, was traded to the Los Angeles Kings. A realtor showed him an expensive house up a very steep driveway. Wayne commented, "I don't think I'll be getting up that in the winter." or words to that effect. Wayne assumed all winters were like the Canadian winters he grew up with. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, I am the first and I am the last, and beside me there is no God. I read this and my ears came to attention. His Redeemer, that could mean one of two things, possibly three. One, his Redeemer could mean the one who redeemed God, but that makes no sense. Save God from who or what? Buy God back from who or what? His Redeemer could be like his prophet, or his messenger, or his ambassador, or his servant. His implies a possessive quality of belonging to or representative of. And I thought, what third option could there be? Does the word his in his Redeemer even appear in the original Hebrew text? Here is the... Cat chewing on my fingers. Here is the first half of Isaiah 44:6. And here is the word whose translation includes Redeemer. Wego alo. It derives from words number 1350 in Strong's Concordance. Notice there are five Hebrew characters. Looking at 1350 in the Strong's Concordance, the short definition says, to redeem, act as kinsman. Notice the base word has only three characters. Here are the five Hebrew characters from the previous page. If you read Hebrew, please shed some light about where the masculine possessive pronoun his comes from. If we examine Isaiah 44:6 again, we see Yahweh Melech Yisrael, Yahweh, the King of Israel. And then we see a second reference to Yahweh, Yahweh Sebaot, Yahweh, the Lord of Hosts. And this is why, and his Redeemer, is such a crucial phrase to fully understand. Is Yahweh the Redeemer a uniquely separable quality of Yahweh God? I ask that because I reviewed the 22 English translations of this verse available on BibleHub, and 17 of the 22 render the translation as his Redeemer. The remaining five provide subtle differences that affect the meaning. Two, the NIV and New Living, render a combined form. The Lord says, Israel's King and Redeemer. This implies two attributes of the same individual, Yahweh. Two, the Holman and International Standard Version render its with a combined form. The Lord says, the King of Israel and its Redeemer. This also implies two attributes of the same individual, Yahweh. But the meaning of the other 17 implies an identifiable, separable situation. Thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel, and his Redeemer, the Lord of Hosts. Yahweh, the King of Israel, and Lord of Hosts, Yahweh of Armies, the Redeemer. As if Yahweh, King of Israel, sends Yahweh, the Redeemer. And both are Yahweh, the Alpha and Omega, the first and last. And in this verse, I can see evidence for both Trinitarianism and Unitarianism. Some see a nice house, others see an ice house. The truth lies in the blank in other scriptures that resolve the ambiguity. In either case, Yahweh God is the Redeemer, meaning he buys back, he pays for those he redeems. Isaiah 47:4. As for our Redeemer, Yahweh, the Lord of Hosts is his name, the Holy One of Israel. Welcome to California. The name of our Redeemer is Yahweh, Lord of Hosts. I consider that a significant piece of Trinitarian evidence for our understanding. Isaiah 48:17, thus saith Yahweh the Lord, thy Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel, I am the Lord thy God, which teaches you to profit, which leads you by the way that you should go. Isaiah 54:8, in a little wrath I hid my face from thee for a moment, but with everlasting kindness will I have mercy on thee, saith the Lord thy Redeemer. Isaiah 59:20, and the Redeemer shall come to Zion, and unto them that turn from transgression in Jacob, saith the Lord.
Beep, beep, back up the truck.
The Redeemer is coming to Zion, to Israel. The Redeemer is Yahweh, the Lord of Hosts. Yahweh, God, the Lord of Hosts, is going to come to Zion, come to Israel. Isaiah 60:16, thou shalt also suck the milk of the Gentiles, and shall suck the breast of kings, and you shall know that I, Yahweh the Lord, am thy Savior and thy Redeemer, the Mighty One of Jacob. Isaiah 63:16, for you are our Father, though Abraham does not know us and Israel does not recognize us. You, O Yahweh Lord, are our Father, our Redeemer from of old is your name. Our Redeemer from of old. This is not a new thing. And notice the concept of God our Father by prophet Isaiah. The prophets reveal God is our Father. The false prophet does not. Zechariah 10:8, I will whistle for them to gather them together, for I have redeemed them, and they will be as numerous as they were before. When I scatter them among the peoples, they will remember me in far countries, and they with their children will live and come back. I will bring them back from the land of Egypt and gather them from Assyria, and I will bring them into the land of Gilead and Lebanon until no room can be found for them. Seems straightforward, but let's go back to the first verse of that passage. I will whistle for them to gather them together, for I have redeemed them. For I have redeemed them. Past tense. Past tense means Yahweh God already has done so. Riddle me this. When? In fact, there are several times when the prophets say God redeemed Israel from their enemies. But studying many examples of reference to the Redeemer, there seems to be a single event that is often presaged. Exodus 6:6, wherefore say unto the children of Israel, I am Yahweh the Lord, and I will bring you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians, and I will rid you out of their bondage, and I will redeem you with a stretched out arm and with great judgments. This mention is God bringing them out of slavery to Egypt. And it came to pass, when Pharaoh would hardly let us go, that the Lord slew all of the firstborn in the land of Egypt, both the firstborn of men and the firstborn of beast. Therefore I sacrifice to the Lord all that opens the womb being males, but all the firstborn of my children I redeem, buy back. Exodus 15:13. For in thy mercy hast led forth the people which thou hast redeemed. Thou hast guided them in thy strength unto thy holy habitation. The concept of redeeming deals with buying back something. Leviticus 25:29, And if a man sell a dwelling house in a walled city, then he may redeem it or buy it back within a whole year after it is sold. Within a full year may he redeem it, buy it back. In Leviticus 25:48, it talks of a slave. After that he is sold, he may be redeemed again. One of his brethren may redeem him, buy him back out of slavery. Redeeming even includes buying back from slavery. I find it utterly inconceivable that God would reveal himself as Redeemer for 1,500 years and then send a last, quote-unquote, prophet who knew nothing about God being the Redeemer. So far, I have focused on the Old Testament mention of Redeemer. God would redeem them. God would buy them back. Let's see what the New Testament says of God the Redeemer. We'll have to get to that in our next video, part 2. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, our Redeemer. Amen.